Now it's a pleasure to introduce Dr. Sophia Neisinger. She's a physician at UK Center, Berlin Charité Institute of Allergology, and she's in charge of research on mast cell driven diseases. And she's going to talk us about cholinergic urticaria.
Thanks a lot, Dr. Jose. I will just share my screen. Okay, hi everyone. I'm very excited to be here today and at this UCare4U webinar on different types of induced urticaria. Today, I'm going specifically to talk about cholinergic urticaria. My name is Sophia Neisinger, and I'm a physician at the UCare Berlin at the Institute of Allergology at Charité. So just to sum up again, we heard it now, what is urticaria? So urticaria is a skin condition that is characterized by the formation of itchy red wheals. So this sentence is what we always hear when talking about cholinergic urticaria, itchy wheals induced by sweating. So cholinergic urticaria is a quite frequently occurring inducible form of urticaria. It is induced by an increase in body core temperature and not by an exogenous physical trigger. As we just heard before, it is in the solar or with the cold urticaria. So the cholinergic urticaria occurs in response to, for instance, physical exercise, emotional stress, spicy food, or even just after having a hot bath. The symptoms only stay for average about 1 hour, but the quality of life of these patients is very disturbed by this. There are also other symptoms that can accompany the itchy wheals, such as, for instance, swellings of the skin, so-called angioedema. And although the physiopathological mechanism of the cholinergic urticaria, as we already heard before, the same with the cold urticaria and the solar urticaria, has not been clearly defined yet, it is thought that histamine and cholinergic agents and other serum factors are related to the development of the symptoms. So to understand the cholinergic urticaria a little bit better and that it's a little bit maybe easier for you as a patient to understand, I had just brought you a very common patient case, one of our patients, Frank. He's a 30-year-old patient. He has a cholinergic urticaria since 1 year, and it started with wheals and itch every week after Frank was playing football. Now he is also getting those wheals every day just by walking outside, just by going to the supermarket. He's already developing those wheals. So that's why the disease now has a really big impact on his quality of life. So Frank came to our outpatient clinic and he has shown us this picture. And as Dr. Kiefer just said before, this is super helpful for us as physicians. So for you as patients, as a tip from our side, just have pictures of your skin lesions always prepared on your phone to show us. And as you can see on the picture, very typical for the cholinergic urticaria, you see little pinpoint sized wheals. And this is indeed different from the skin lesions that we see, for instance, in patients with chronic spontaneous urticaria or with solar urticaria or with cold urticaria. So those skin lesions can occur anywhere on the body except for the palms, the soles, and the axilla. But the most commonly affected part of the body is the trunk and the extremities. So before we said itchy wheals, but in patients with cholinergic urticaria, in contrast to other types of urticaria, many patients are complaining that they sometimes even feel some tingling pain and sometimes even no itch. So of course, the correct diagnosis, as always, is key. After talking to Frank and seeing those pictures, we thought the diagnosis of a cholinergic urticaria might be possible. Because the symptoms of cholinergic urticaria develop after an increase in body temperature, a provocation test should be performed. So this provocation test for the diagnosis of the cholinergic urticaria is performed by just increasing the body temperature through exercise. You can either use whatever your doctor has, a treadmill or a stationary bicycle, or even the use of a hot bath. And what we recommend other clinics to do is use a standardized protocol for diagnosing and measuring cholinergic urticaria thresholds using a pulse-controlled ergometry. As you can see on the picture, as a patient, you would just have, for instance, to bicycle in the outpatient clinic to provoke your itchy wheels. There are two differential diagnoses that have to be mentioned. On the one hand, it's the cold urticaria that we already heard about. And on the other hand, it's the exercise-induced anaphylaxis. This is an exercising after a food ingestion that leads to an anaphylaxis. Just for you to have it heard, but it might be too complicated to go further into it. So the guideline for the treatment is always the same in urticaria. So also as in the other types that we heard about before, we always start with a second generation non-sedating antihistamine. And after 2 or 4 weeks, we evaluate how you as a patient are doing, and then we might increase the dose of this antihistamine. This is the step 2 you can now see on the slide. After this, as Dr. Kiefer also said before, there is an antibody treatment that might be possible, omalizumab. This would also be an off-label use. And then there are also immunosuppressants, for instance, that can be used. Going back to our patient, Frank. Frank was in our outpatient clinic. He had no treatment until then. So we have put him on an H1 antihistamine, as, for instance, loratadine. Maybe you have heard of it. And then we planned a follow-up call. And in the follow-up call, Frank said he did improve a lot. He only develops those skin lesions after a lot of exercising, just about once per week. So what we did, we talked to him and explained that an increase of the antihistamine is possible to take it up to 4 times per day, also as an off-label use, but it is, we say this would be the right way for him to do, and we are planning another follow-up call. And I hope with this little case of Frank, it is a little bit easier to understand how the cholinergic urticaria, what it does, and how it should be treated. I tried to sum it up a little bit faster so that we might have even some time for questions. I want to thank all the other speakers. That was very, very interesting. And if you're a patient and just have any simple questions, the chat is free to use, and I will give back to Jose. Thank you.
Thank,